are you?
Hi.
Hello.
Hi. Hello. So, hola. As people out there might not know you at present, we've got to start with all these basic questions, like, for what's Linkin Park? Was it a place where you hung around?
Yes.
Yeah. Yes.
Don't address any questions to him.
Okay.
He's not really got real.
Okay. And who's the clever one?
He'll be the serious one for this interview.
Okay.
I'm the smart one.
He's the smart one, and he's the serious one.
So, like, yeah, Linkin Park, a place where you hung around?
It's a place in Santa Monica in Los Angeles. It's named after the American president, Abraham Lincoln. We spelled it differently so that we could get the web domain name for a far cheaper price.
far fewer Deutschmarks.
And the thing is, it's everywhere. In every town there is this Linkin Park, so it's like being the town's band.
Actually, ironically, like, the cool thing is like, when we show up, like, when we toured the States, mm-hmm. Everywhere we went, we were like locals. Like, yeah. All the kids would come up and be like, hey, dude, we live in Linkin Park too, man. Which street did you grow up on? And we're just like...
The joke was that we could never be like a professional band because we were always a local band.
And the fact that we can't really play our instruments.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Especially Brad.
Okay.
Especially me.
Linkin Park, das ist ein Park in L.A., wo sie immer abgehangen sind. Und Linkin Park gibt es auch überall. Und das ist auch ganz cool, weil in jeder Stadt, wo sie kommen, meinen die jungen Leute dort immer wieder, das ist eine regionale Band. Aber nein, Linkin Park ist international. So, what was before? Yeah, that fits quite good together. It's like glamorous.
Do you want to trade later and maybe I'll use some of your nail polish?
Yeah, I could lend you some lipstick as well, and we could do like a makeup session. But
or that. We could say that we did it, and then we could really have Chester put on lipstick because I think he'd look a lot better.
Brad looks really good in a dress.
Like a rouge.
So you've got all this feminine stuff around
right,
here.
Right, that's because I'm very secure with my sexuality.
So what was before Linkin Park? Any transvestite shows or something like that? Nothing?
No. That's why we call the band Hybrid Theory, because Brad was kind of a hybrid between a man and a woman.
It was originally Hermaphrodite Theory.
No, but some of you guys met in school, some of you...
Yeah, we all pretty much met in school. Except for Chester, he's the outcast.
He didn't go to school.
I dropped out of school.
He didn't go to third grade. But if he did go to school, we would have met him in school too. Mm-hmm. Brad and I had known each other since we were about 13. Joe and I met in college. Brad and Phoenix met in college. Mm-hmm. And Rob and Brad and I went to high school in the same area.
Okay.
And Chester.
And they found me in a desert 600 miles away.
You know, it was like something, you were looking for a singer and then you were there.
They were looking for a singer and they'd been auditioning singers for like, almost four months in LA, mm-hmm. and every vocalist in LA did not pass the test, so they had to seek elsewhere. Mm-hmm. And we had a mutual friend, Scott Harrington, who called me up and said, you know, I have a band, you should really just check it out, and I'll send you a demo, and he did, and within a matter of days, I had cut my version of the demo and sent it in, and I was in LA, and they kept me there ever since, chained.
Cool.
In the studio.
Well, so here we are. Also, wie sie zusammengekommen sind, die meisten hier kennen sich ja schon aus der Schule und Chester ist dazugekommen, wie sie nach einem Sänger Ausschau gehalten haben. Wir haben eben einen gemeinsamen Freund und er kommt aus Arizona, die anderen kommen alle aus LA. Und jetzt gibt's erstmal was von Linkin Park zu hören für euch. Jo. Und weiter geht's hier mit Linkin Park im Hintergrund, einer der lacht und der Hamburger Hafen. Und ich sitze jetzt hier mit den Herren. So,
I've got two ways I can wear my hat.
Choice.
And I kind of want, I know we can't get immediate feedback. Mm-hmm. But maybe people could go to our website, linkinpark.com, mm-hmm. and tell us. There's this way where you don't see my eyebrows, mm-hmm. and then there's this way.
Wow, so this looks so different.
We could get some kind of like mm-hmm. response from the German public as to which is more flattering.
I'll write you this stuff. So, also ihr habt gehört, ihr könnt ihm schreiben, wie er seinen Hut zu tragen hat, entweder über den Augenbrauen oder nicht, aber er ist auch ein Schmarrn. Jetzt reden wir mal über die Platte. So, Hybrid Theory.
Who gave him hash browns this morning?
Yeah. So,
tell everybody that we think that Brad's on drugs.
Yeah, er soll auf Drogen sein, aber ich weiß nicht. Ich glaube, der ist immer so. Und jetzt reden wir mal über die Platte. So, let's talk about this record. It's a hybrid between rap, rock, and electronic thing. Is it like everybody of you get this hybrid taste in music, or are there any masters of rock, any masters of rap, or how does it work?
I think we all like a lot of different things. We may have a little more practice in one thing than others, mm-hmm. but we definitely are being distracted by our DJ.
Mm-hmm, yeah. So there's...
There are bands that, like, and musicals, musical taste that we all have in common, mm-hmm. but then each of us kind of brings to the table something different that, mm-hmm. that he listened to growing up and has, like, shared that with the rest of mm-hmm. the group.
And what's the unique thing where you all fit together, like, bands you all like?
What bands do we like in common? Mm-hmm. Well, I think one of our favorite bands is the Deftones. Mm-hmm. And the fact that they asked us to tour with them in March here in Europe is like, I still don't believe it. Like, I won't believe it until we play our first show. And then other bands that we think are great are Incubus, Papa Roach, who we also toured with. Mm-hmm. And we're taking out two groups actually on our headlining tour in the United States. One's called Taproot, mm-hmm. and one is called Styles of Beyond. Mm-hmm. They're more of an underground rap group from Los Angeles.
Also, sie machen ja mehr so den hybriden Sound. Das heißt, sie mischen Rap und Rock und dann auch elektronische Elemente. Es ist so, dass sie alle irgendwie den gleichen Musikgeschmack haben. Also Bands, die sie irgendwie alle verehren, ist zum Beispiel Papa Roach und Deftones. Mit den Deftones werden sie jetzt auch im Februar auf Tour sein. So, the cover art is really, really interesting and I think it's one of the best covers I really saw. Really.
Thank you. I did too, that's why I got it tattooed on my leg.
Really?
Show the camera.
You also can show your
You want to see the tattoo?
Yeah.
Oh. Look at my skinny chicken legs.
Wow, that's great. That's really cool. Also, you can see in here, cover. Come on here, come on. So it's a soul show with butterfly wings.
The thing about the cover that we wanted to do is that obviously a lot of people are familiar with a musical hybrid. We wanted something that was more us, mm-hmm. that was more personal. And so we being that we mix heavier sounds and more sensitive elements in our music, we wanted to do something with the soldier being the heavier thing and the dragonfly wings being more delicate.
And Mike drew mm-hmm. this.
It's also like the sound of your music, like the voice is sometimes so soft and so nice, and that's a butterfly thing and it's all of it.
Right.
Smash it, yeah. So, die Coverart. Sie haben sich ja Folgendes ausgedacht, die Musik, die ist ja zum Teil doch sehr, sehr weich und sehr etwas fürs Herz, eben die Stimme auch, die eben sehr sanft auch oft ist, drum halt diese Flügel und der Soldat, der spiegelt halt dann mehr so die Rock-Elemente so voll auf die Fresse, weil das ist nämlich auch bei Linkin Park zu hören. Und für euch gibt's jetzt erstmal Musik, wir sehen uns danach hier in Hamburg mit Linkin Park. So, Linkin Park, wie geht's hier weiter? Hier in Hamburg für euch, so. We are just living in Nukiland. There are all these bands out like 28 days. There are Limp Bizkit, there is Papa Roach. And what do you think about this big development in crossover music?
I think that the development of the crossover music is just like another evolution that's taking place in music itself. It's not like a phenomenon mm-hmm. that just like kind of came out of nowhere. These bands that have made it have kind of made it on their own because they didn't really have much of an influence or something to kind of look up to with mm-hmm. the similar styles. It's all kind of been original, and that's why I think we all sound so different. Mm-hmm. It's kind of odd to be lumped in the same genre with bands like the Deftones and Incubus and Limp Bizkit and Korn and Slipknot mm-hmm. and then us, Linkin Park. I don't think any of the bands sound anything alike at all, mm-hmm. but we all share a common thread, and that is that we are mixing mm-hmm. something and we're trying something different.
Yeah, the difference is what I've found at the first, like when I first heard it, is like, especially your voice, it's so different, it's so, you know, it's like a real voice, so you could sing, and most of them are just like, oh, you know, this screaming, and yours is more, yeah.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, so there is a difference. Which difference do you else see in your music to the others?
I think the main difference is just simply the fact that it's kind of hard to say, but we really tried to avoid talking about any type of political mm-hmm. situation, and we avoided any violence. And we also unconsciously didn't use any vulgarity on mm-hmm. our record. And I think that those are things that kind of really step out, especially lyrically, because kids can appreciate, they seem to appreciate our honesty in our lyrics rather than just kind of coming up with something to try to sound tough or sound like you know what you're talking about, so.
Ja, also wir leben ja zurzeit gerade im Nuki-Land. Das heißt, es gibt ganz viele Bands wie 28 Days, Limp Bizkit und POD, wie sie denn alle heißen. Sie sehen ihren Unterschied darin, dass sie nicht unbedingt mit politischen Meinungen um sich schleudern müssen, um irgendwelche Leute an sich zu ziehen. Nein, sie versuchen halt mehr so vom Leben selbst zu erzählen. Und Linkin Park, also Chester hat ja auch eine hervorragende Stimme, die im Vergleich zu den anderen dann doch mehr auf Melodie Wert gelegt wird. So. Do you think at present it's easier to do a crossover thing, like that the people are open-minded for it, or is it more difficult because there are so many crossover bands out there?
I think it's difficult to find good crossover bands. I think that the companies have done a real good job at selecting them because, I mean, it's not a very simple task. It takes a lot. We've worked very, very hard and diligently at making sure that our parts flow well together, that there isn't just a hip-hop part and then the rock part and then the electronica interlude, you know?
Yeah.
We really wanted everything to be fluent, and that's not something that's easy, and you can't just spend a couple hours a day, a couple times a week doing that. It really took a lot of our time and energy, and I think that the more music and the more bands that that people are exposed to that do crossover, we're going to see a surgence of that even more so in the future.
Okay, wo Sie auch Ihren Unterschied sehen, ist das, dass Sie mit Ihrer Musik halt jetzt nicht unbedingt, dass man, wenn man jetzt ein Lied hört, aha, jetzt kommt also der Rap-Part und jetzt kommt der Rock-Part. Sie versuchen das alles irgendwie schön, dass das schön in sich reingeht und schöne Übergänge sind. Und die Plattenindustrie, die bringt ja zurzeit ganz, ganz viele verschiedene solcher Bands raus, aber Sie glauben eben durch das, dass Sie anders sind in Ihrer Musik, wird sich da auch einiges für Sie tun. Und jetzt gibt's erstmal Crossover von euch für euch, Papa Roach mit Broken Home. Yeah. So, meine Lieben, hier geht's noch weiter mit Linkin Park hier in Hamburg, im Hintergrund der wunderbare Hafen. So, Chester, I once heard that you said in an interview that since you learned talking, you were telling the people that you want to become a singer.
Yes.
And that's really nice, and I think that sounds very optimistic, and that's a bit of American philosophy that they, you know, they've got this go for it thing. And do you think that sometimes people have their worst enemies in themselves, like giving themselves borderlines?
Absolutely. I think one of the biggest weaknesses of being a person, just in general as a human being, is the feeling that you know, we're all a little bit insignificant in the large picture of things, and which is completely untrue. Every person can be as powerful and as they want to be, or as weak as they want to be. It's just, you know, the drive isn't in everybody, and I think everyone can accomplish anything they want to do in their lives.
Do you think everyone's talented in their own ways?
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. I think it's just a way of finding it and having the support to you know, get that talent out and push you, because sometimes, I mean, even though I've been determined to do this my entire life, there have been times where I needed my friends or my family and my loved ones to kind of keep pushing me on, saying keep doing it, you know. So through all of those things combined, I think people, everyone can accomplish amazing things, you know.
Ja, ihr könnt alles erreichen, wenn ihr nur an euch glaubt, weil er hat damals schon als kleiner Junge gesagt, bevor er richtig reden können hat, so, ich werde Sänger, ich werde Sänger, und hat fest daran geglaubt, und jetzt ist er auch hier. Und das ist ja auch so ein bisschen so eine amerikanische Philosophie, dass man halt mehr so sagt, go for it, mach es einfach, und so, yeah, it's this American philosophy, go for it, which is like, I've got some friends in America, and always when I'm talking about new plans and projects I want to do, they're also, yeah, do it, and Europeans are more like, are you sure about that?
It's definitely there's definitely a vibe about just American culture throughout the history. Just, it's been a place where, you know, through from the beginning, a place where people go to start over.
That's really
and try something new, and I think that you know, still stands pretty strong in our society, and there's a lot of freedom to do things and express yourselves in a lot of different ways. So you know, we've just been lucky. To get those things and the dreams accomplished, you know.
Die amerikanische Philosophie von wegen, ja, man kann alles erreichen, erklärte sich dadurch, dass ja Amerika ist ja auch irgendwann mal entstanden worden, und die ganzen Einwanderer, die haben ja auch was schaffen müssen, und es ist eben ein wunderbarer Kontinent draus geworden. Und so it's time for your requested clips, guys. And you want to hear?
What do we want to hear? We want to hear Prodigy.
Can I take both of them?
You can.
We want to hear Prodigy smack my bitch up, and we want to hear Head PE bartender.
Für euch. Yeah. So, meine lieben Turok-Zuschauer, jetzt geht's dem Ende zu. Ich habe gerade Limp Bizkit gesehen und weiter geht's hier mit Linkin Park in Hamburg. So, what's coming up next? There is this Deftones tour. Yeah.
That's right. Well, we're going to be in Europe for the whole month of March with the Deftones and I believe Taproot. All the dates for those shows I know will be on our website, which is linkinpark.com. And really, this week's been our first introduction to playing Europe, and we're really excited to come back in March and keep coming back.
What do you think so far of Germany?
Germany's great.
Mm-hmm.
We just did. We did a couple days in Paris, and we've only been in Germany for about just six to 8 hours. But
yeah.
And we've been in this building the entire time.
Okay, this building is great.
No, it's true. So,
but the view. I mean, seriously, the view. I'm so glad they put us in this building because the view. We've seen the entire all of Hamburg from this one room, from this one building, and it's really incredible.
And so far, our experience with German McDonald's has been Zupa.
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 Zupa. What happened there?
We had McDonald's.
Yeah. We finally had American.
Also, in Deutschland gefällt es Ihnen, bei McDonald's gefällt es Ihnen. Sie hatten einfach nur ein paar Burger. Sie sind jetzt erst seit 8 Stunden hier, also kann man auf das Urteil jetzt noch nicht so viel Wert legen, aber soweit gefällt es Ihnen. Sie waren zuvor in Paris, werden aber im Februar mit den Deftones kommen. And any personal wishes? Anything like?
No more fromage.
I have mad cow disease.
No more fromage. Sorry?
I have mad cow disease.
You can, oh. And how does it look like? You start screaming or?
I don't
like,
know.
You don't know. Also, yeah.
That's why we like. That's why Joe's in the band.
Yeah. Okay.
Just that's comic relief.
That's the only reason.
Comic relief.
Anything else? Sometimes what should happen comic with you? Like the Grammy.
Yeah, we're gonna win every category in the Grammys,
including best country artist.
Chester's gonna win best female artist.
Yeah, I'm gonna win. Yeah, I'm
best
gonna win
solo female artist.
Yeah, and we're gonna take over every music video station in the entire planet, and they will play strictly Linkin Park.
Our only video.
And polka.
Our only video.
And yeah, we're,
over and over.
Yeah, we're starting a new hybrid of polka
again.
Core music.
Polka core, that's
which is
interesting.
Like, yeah, we're gonna start incorporating polka beats with our hip hop, you know,
so,
rock stuff.
Yeah, so when we take over every countdown and video station, we're gonna play our video and polka core.
Polka core.
Over and over.
That's cool.
Day.
Anything about the moon or something like that? Or
just
polka the core. World, man. Okay.
I was
don't
not informed
confuse
with
it.
Any of this. Nobody ever told me. Yes.
That's because you've got mad cow disease and your days are numbered.
Yeah, your days are numbered. You're gonna
have a replacement for you.
This, der arme Kerl, der hat ohne Scheiß BSI. Und die Jungs, die werden auf die Welt rocken. Die wollen nämlich Polka core machen. Also so ein Hybrid aus Polka und Hardcore Crossover Things. Ja. Es wird einiges passieren. Wir werden noch viel von Ihnen hören. Talent haben Sie. Ihr seht jetzt noch was von dem Talent. Nehme ich. Jetzt hier Linkin Park für euch live. Und that was it. You can say bye bye to the audience.
Oh, bye bye.
Bye
audience. Bye. Bye. So rocky kicks.
the ups and downs. Pollution manifested in perpetual sound. No wheels go round and the sunset breeze by the street.
Thank you.